One of the things you need to do to program in Java on your computer is install the Java Development Kit, also known as the JDK. And that's what we're going to do in this video. Specifically, we're going to install the JDK version 11 for a Windows 10 machine. So if you're running Windows 10, you're in the right place. And if you're on a Mac or a Linux machine, check out my channel because I've also got videos for those operating systems as well. But enough chit chat, let's get into the Windows 10 installation of the JDK 11. Alright, so this is the Windows installation video. Skip this if you're on a Mac or you're running Linux. Alright, so we've established now that you want to install Java 11, or in our case, the JDK or Java Development Kit version 11. There is one gotcha for Windows users though, and that's if you're running a 32-bit version of Microsoft Windows. In that case, Oracle don't provide 32-bit versions of the Java Development Kit anymore. You'll have to install an older version of the Java Development Kit if your computer has the 32-bit version of Windows. Most modern computers these days are running a 64-bit version, but how do you actually know if your computer is running a 32-bit or a 64-bit version of Windows? What you need to do is firstly get into Control Panel in Windows. So I'm going to come down here and right-click on the Windows icon and select Settings. That will usually work for most versions of Windows. Then you want to go into System. Now in my case, because I'm running Windows 10, I can actually type System, and then I get an option down here. I'm just going to type in System. About halfway down here, we can see About Your PC. I'm going to click on that. And that's how I can get to the screen that I need to get to. Now, if you're not running Windows 10, you'll need to go into System, and then you'll find an option for About. So either way, we'll get to the screen here, and it should look very similar to this if you're not running Windows 10. And the bit we're down looking for down here is this under System Type, 64-bit operating system, x64-based processor. The important bit is a bit on the left, which in my case says 64-bit operating system. So that's telling me then, obviously, I'm running a 64-bit version, and therefore I can use the JDK version 11. But if you do this and find on your computer it says 32-bit operating system, then you'll need to install the older version of the JDK. All right, so I'm going to close this down, and armed with that knowledge, we can go grab the correct JDK. So to do that, we're going to go to, I've got a browser open, I'm going to go to java.sun.com. All right, so once we get to this Oracle page, we're going to come up here and click on Java SE. Java SE, by the way, stands for Java Standard Edition, and that's what we're going to be using in this course. So you can see when I've done that on the screen now, we've got Java SE 11, and in parentheses, we can see LTS. So LTS means long-term support. So at this point, if you are running a 64-bit version of Windows like I am, you come over here to the right under Oracle JDK, click on Download. That'll bring the Downloads page up for the JDK version 11. I'm going to scroll down a little bit. I'm going to click on Accept License Agreement. Then I'm going to come down here to Windows. I'm going to click on the executable. I'm going to click on Run down here. And while that's downloading, I'm going to show you what the 32-bit version would look like. So if you're running a 32-bit version of Windows, you can't download this version, or you can download it, but you'll find it won't work. So instead what you do is you'll go back. And instead you'll scroll down a little bit further, noting that there's a Java 10 version there, but we'll ignore that. And we'll come down here to Java SE 8. This is the version of Java that will work, was the last version that worked for 32-bit users. Then you'll come down here to JDK download, click on that. And under the options here, we've got two versions, Windows x86 and Windows x64. So in the case of 32-bit users, you would select this file here, this i586 version, which is the x86 version, and download it as you saw me download the JDK version 11, but obviously that would be Java Development Kit version 8. I'm just going to click on Yes to start my installation. So again, that would only be the, you'd only need to do that if you had a 32-bit version of Windows. And in my case, I've got the 64-bit, and that's what I'm going to download. So I'm going to go back now just to that page again, and that was the version that I selected up here, Java 11. So at this point, once you've downloaded either Java 11 or Java 8, you'll find that the installation process when you start it will be very similar. So I'm going to go through the installation steps now for JDK 11. I'm going to click on Next there. I'm going to leave the default, but keep a note of what this folder is. In my case, you can see it's /program/files/java/JDK11. And that will be slightly different if you've downloaded the JDK 8. Click on Next. And it's a fairly simple installation process, which we'll go through. At this point, we're actually done. So I'm going to click on Close now. All right, so thanks for watching. If you've got questions, leave a comment. If you're ready for the next programming-specific video, click on the link up here in the top left-hand corner of your screen. To look at non-coding programming-related questions, click on the link down the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. Feel free to subscribe by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you in another video.